it's possible to hack your brain so you can outsmart a lie detector. The latest in lie detection technology involves literally scanning someone's brain using an MRI to determine if they're concealing something or not. But a new study suggests that there are at least two methods that people can use to beat this system. I'm Justin with Inverse, the coolest place to get smarter. Let's get mischievous. fMRI-based lie detectors could be the future of truth detection technology. It uses brain imaging to map blood flow throughout certain regions of the brain in order to determine the link between brain chemistry and behavior. Generally, what the researchers are looking for is the moment when someone sees or hears the thing that they want to keep hidden and then start to scramble to cover it up. Actively trying to conceal something is the biggest red flag for lie detectors, and brain imaging is very good at picking it up. A study published in the journal Human Brain Mapping is meant to find ways to cheat around this behavior to trip up the test. In this study, subjects were given a specific number selected out of a pool of numbers and told to keep this number a secret. Then they were shown various numbers on a screen. Normally, when your secret number would appear on the screen, your brain scans would light up as you tried to not appear excited about it. Even minor recognition gets recorded in an fMRI and usually appears in readings in the prefrontal cortex. However, certain subjects were taught various methods to try and properly hide this reaction. Here are the two methods that showed real results. The first method involved removing the meaning of a word or object and focusing on the superficial elements of it. In their test, the subjects were told to focus on the physical elements of the number they were meant to keep hidden. So if your number was 5, whenever a number appeared on the screen, you'd have to really focus on the look of the number 5, the curves of the font, like the colors on the screen, stuff like that. This helps strip away emotional connection to whatever is being withheld. The 3 has 2 curves, the 8 has 4, the 5 has 1. Suddenly, the fMRI isn't receiving red flags. It goes back to Aristotle's Poetics, where he described Plato's theory of mimesis, how representations of things add distance between the original. So basically, if someone were asking you about a murder weapon, there's a big difference between being presented with the actual knife than being shown a picture of the knife or just, you know, simply saying the word knife. Each step further away allows the brain to focus on superficial elements that do not trigger certain brain responses. The shine of the metal of the knife, the lighting in the picture of the knife, or just the way that knife starts with a K? I mean, how weird is that? The second method involved giving meaning to other words or objects in order to throw the lie detector off the scent. So, using numbers, instead of trying to hide the number 5 by focusing on how not special it is, simply give special meaning to other numbers. Okay, if this doesn't make sense, let me give you an example. So, let's say 3 is now the luckiest number. If a 3 appears on that screen, it's a sign and we're all going to Vegas. Or, remember that show, John and Kate plus 8? That was just terrible. If the number 8 appears on the screen, we all have to binge watch the first season tonight in one sitting. Dear God, I hope there's not an 8. The fMRI tests are meant to identify when the brain is trying to avoid or cover something. If you're doing this for multiple elements, the tests will be ineffective, at least in theory. It turns out these methods were actually very effective. The accuracy of these lie detection tests were diminished by 20% when subjects utilized either or both of these methods. That's a significant chunk of error that could easily lead to the test being thrown out or deemed inconclusive. Because of these cheats, fMRI testing is not considered more effective than other measures, such as skin conductance, like sweat. However, when the technology does become foolproof, it'll definitely be the future of lie detection technology. All right, which technique do you guys think you'd be better at? Removing meaning from an object or placing meaning on other objects? I think I'd be good at the first one, but I'm honestly a terrible liar, so who knows? Just let me know in the comments below. And if you guys like science, if you like data, cool YouTube videos where you learn something new every day, subscribe to Inverse, give that little bell a tap, and believe me, I'll know if you're lying or not. So, in conclusion, while it might seem backwards, the study is for the benefit of the technology, not people who are trying to lie professionally like you or me. It's important to know the flaws of your own test so you can improve and adjust accordingly. These methods can be studied now in order to make sure they won't work in the future. It's like hiring a master thief to break into your high security bank so you can see which elements need to be reworked, but then, you know, obviously you and the thief, you fall in love, and then you work together to rob the bank from under the noses of the board members. Well, that's a pretty good idea. I'm gonna write that down. Love has no locks. Can't hide this love. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think.